A map we've seen an awful lot of. Win percentage, taking a look at it. It's been 10 maps for OG and only 30%, 3 out of 10 victories. And for Fnatic, significantly less. Let's see how this one shapes up. Their pretty faces on your screens, and we are ready to get this one started. Okay. That nade! Colossal, Brawl and Issa both filling the feed, but look at the damage. I still can't quite believe that. Golden and Flusher are working with 23 points of health between them.
Yeah, put that in your pipe and smoke it. That's not the way you want to be kicking off the map here. And we know Fnatic had a relatively brawly T side on train when we casted them just the other day. Then they had to mount a massive comeback on their CT
side. Who do I give credit to for that nade? Was it Alexi with the kit nade? Was it a Mantu? There's a lot of, there's a couple of candidates, but it came from Bomb Train. And
I think
now
it must have just been Alexi.
Yeah. Let's see if he can finish it off the damage he found. We might get answers if he takes down Flusher, see if he gets an assist or not. And tapping away, holding the cross. No one's there. Oh, hello, JW. Hello, Crims. They start to show. Looks like it could be the commitment. Alexi finds one. Crims, that was a healthy member down. Flusher makes the low HP sing. Jiggle, cost him his life. It was Alexi's nade. And now Valda can wrap this one up. It's JW, a lot of pressure, but a USP. Chance now onto Issa. Doesn't find the head. There is a flank, there is a timer. He has to check it, and he does. Albeit just a second too late, NBK gets the crosshair where it needs to be. And OG, take the pistol.
Do we have that nade?
I can show it for everyone playing at home from a skybox perspective to give you the look of where it's thrown from. So you can see here, Alexi B, he's going to be tooling it towards the front of the bomb train, and it goes through these windows here above pop. So as we play this out, you see Alexi standing, he's lining it up, he's getting it ready, he's waiting for the timer. You've got Mantu in towards pop for any sound cues or early information. Nade comes on through, dunks on down, and you can see that damage that is done just there. So that was definitely Alexi B kicking things off for the side of OG, and they will win the pistol, they'll convert, and immediately the org coming out for MBK, who had that defuse. Yeah, well, he's going to get to pop very quickly.
The Kraken.
Yeah, the pop.
It's Cobble. I'm rolling my mind back. I love it. I like to see it.
It would be interesting for them to play in Pop Dog, knowing they were going up against the save. And they're playing a bit more passive. So JW, I think he's out of luck here.
Yeah, I think this one ends
quickly.
Yeah, he does get one chance, but Alexi continues to stack up his utility damage. Flusher playing with a ladder, flirting with Issa.
God, that really was just like a nostalgic wave, seeing that gun in his hands.
It's sword off JW, iconic mix. Yeah.
But
just peeks into that org.
Exactly. This looks comfortable. You know, so the SMGs maybe mop up a little here.
Knife, loser. It could have been 1,500. That's my analysis. I'm just saying, if they need $1,500 at some point, Chad, it's Alexi's fault.
All right. Yeah. Well, we can point fingers.
Yeah, I'm ready to.
I'll make note.
Now, the bomb did go down, and Fnatic didn't opt to force buy in. They just went the light upgrade here of pistols. Crims, you can see him. Oh, well, he's been seen as well. So Issa will drop Crims. Clean round here for OG, and now the guns will come out on the side of Fnatic. JW could glass cannon if they want off the bat here. And this was dealing with that of JW. So aggressive as you like, JW, we do expect that with him, but not being able to find much damage whatsoever. As the buy will come on through, utility looking decent.
If you've got a scout, an MP9, and a FAMAS, are you calling something a bit different here?
Yeah, and we have seen a lot of these bonus rounds be converted from OG, especially when they played FaZe Clan just the other day. So let's see what they have in store for us right here. It looks like a five-man yard lane. Vold is actually setting up the deep smoke from Connector towards the box holes. And look at this from Alexi. He wants to chase, but he's in the flames. Alexi, you've overstayed. You're welcome, my friend. Flusher gets a freebie. Rush, can we just show the Volda smoke towards box holes quickly? Yeah, this one here, see that deep? Volda throws that from Connector. If it is a yard rush, he can help immediately through the Connector position, and he actually slows down their attack towards that inner bomb site. But if Fnatic know that Volda's the one throwing it, they might actually just be able to run on down and go straight down low ramp. So keep that in mind as the game progresses.
Yeah, okay, so it's a question of whether or not he's behind it or not. Grim's going to get some damage here at ear, so it might go a little shy. Yeah, very insignificant. Now, Issa, we saw he's statistically the second highest rated player for OG, and that smoke will arrive. Valda looking to exit here. He's trying to get away from the flames. Burns down. It's a frag traded by the flames from the grave. 4-on-3. CTs have a lot to do here, and it's a complete inner hit.
Lovely. And then you're going to have Golden just being a real nuisance around the back lines of things, around those back tracks. And yes, Mantu can watch for it. They seem aware of it, but it's a problem they have to now clear.
Is there any way they could get them? Mantu upgrade, there's an AK, there's another kill. No, Fnatic, don't let this one slip away. Crims takes the initiative, takes the shot, takes the fight. And so an AK and an AUG will be preserved.
All right, well, wasn't as successful as OG would have liked here, but it was a bonus round. So the buy coming through into the next, it will be decent. Mantu, and they get the 1,400 loss bonus, which will put him on up to 4K. Will anyone be able to drop him an AWP? No. So going into the next round, it will just be five rifles coming on out on the side of things for OG. Everyone should be able to purchase on in. MBK can drop, Mantu can drop. And they'll make this one work. But here was Alexi V overstaying his welcome and just going down towards that Molotov.
Two molly kills.
Mm. Yeah, that's unusual to see, especially on either sides of the map. It was Krims just dealing with that flank pressure, and once that comes in, that would completely take the round away from OG. First round on the board for Fnatic here. Now, just remember how the game against Complexity went the other day for Fnatic. They had to battle back into it. It was a very, very rough game for them. But in the first half, they lost the 2v1 on the pistol round to Poison. They lost a lot of close mid-round situations in Yard. If they can tidy those up here today, they could be running away with 6 or 7 rounds on the T side. But the battle for Pop, it continues as Flasho shows his legs, and so we'll get mollied on back out of dodge. Does a little bit of damage.
NBK very committed to the fight here on Brown Halls. No one's giving it to him just yet. Krim's jiggling. Oh, this is getting sketchy. Well handled. NBK wants to drop the incendiary to ensure that AK can't be retrieved. It will eventually fall into the hands of Flusher. Mantu, a duel for him. A molly from J-Dubs, forcing them further back. A flash won't buy too much time. Now it becomes the responsibility of Valda.
Ooh, called in and dispatches of two. Really well handled by Valda there. Nice little communication. No pressure really was felt, even with Mantu forced away from that.
Quite a slow approach here. I painted this one as going to be very, very brawly, but Fnatic, if they can't get out into the yard and they can't make these into mid-round situations, they will just have to saunter around the map and look for frags. And at this point, in a 2-on-5 situation, heading over towards the B site, looks like it's been red. MBK close low ramp in tow. Valda with an AUG as well. So a double AUG hold on the CT side here. Should be able to lock these down even against the AK-47s. Smokes to work with. Can cut off a couple of lines of sight here. Interesting smoke there from... Is that Brolin who threw that? That's very curious.
Well, that one's worked quite nicely. MBK, very uncomfortable. And now the cross is available-ish. Spray to try and cover off. Flusher trying to keep them safe, but can't get away with his life. Leaving Brolin in a 1v3. It's pretty clutch for Fnatic last time we saw him, using the smoke as best he can, but now it's faded. Now it's just him and the gun by his side. Three very hungry CTs, and Mantu's won it out. So the retake works out, the bomb gets defused, and another goes on the board for OG.
We've seen some geeky nades within these first four rounds. That one from Brolin bouncing it off there through the skylight, lands on down and operates as a bit of a one-way. And also opened the doorway for Flusher towards the high ramp using his own smoke to go for the pick and take MBK out. So getting the plant down, that's fantastic news for Fnatic here in a round that they probably never should have had a shot in. And as you can see, they will be able to get a buy forward off of this if they'd like. AKs, the Lils, that's the purchase right there. Is Valda towards the yard position doing a great job dealing with that Ivy presence. Now,
the slowed down AK sound, one of my faves. This guy's underwater. Respect for tuning in. So many leagues under the sea.
Is that a jellyfish in the background?
It was, yeah. Watch out for the Great Whites. Timeout called, and it's the first of our semi-final. Fnatic just wanting to get their heads screwed on tight for this Deagle armor. First timeout, 4 per map. If you're wondering how it all works out, every map you get that refresher. Extra 30 seconds to call at your own whim.
They've just gone for a light investment here, Fnatic. So with the cash they're working with, in the next round they get 2,400. So keeping their money around that 2K mark. And as you can see here, Deagles and a P250 for Flusher will be purchased on through. A couple of HEs, potentially using those through the T connector towards that bomb train, and some smokes to work with as well. So let's see how Fnatic want to approach this one just here. They know that they can still be deadly on these Deagles. Just need to find a OG member making a mistake. So they've done the standard smokes towards Yard. This is E-Box and the 5-lane smokes. This is for conditioning's purposes.
They threw them and they did nothing.
Yeah, so here they just, you want to see how much utility you can force out of OG. When you see those smokes land, traditionally you're going to see a Molotov, a Flash, and probably a HE towards Team A. But if those smokes land and they think you can get out into the Olaf position, another Molotov over towards Olaf, more Flashes to push forward and to clear out that zone. Because if they don't clear it out, eventually there might be a gap, there might be a timing, and you can get punished. So we can see at this point, Fnatic are playing that percentage CS. They are melting down OG's utility just by using the clock on their side. At this point, two smokes, a Molotov, a flash, make it two, and a HE remaining here. So that's all the OG have for the end of this round. That means they have to reinvest in the following. Now, can they convert?
Yeah, nice little flash does allow them out, but it's once they get here, what do they do with it? You've got rifles against you and not too much utility remaining. So I guess at least they've succeeded on that front. A plant would have been lovely as an addition. MBK careful now. Has to hit the reload. Falls back away, comes back in, isolates Golden. That's a pickup. This is clean so far until Crims gets into the matter.
If I'm Alexei, I don't want to go down here. I've got an AK-47, two of my teammates, or rather one of them has as well. So he'll just stand still, let his with that M4 go hunting, and he'll find it. So that's OG4, Fnatic 1. They'll be back into the AKs now. But weathering the storm without losing too many casualties is certainly good signs.
Yeah, and they don't want to get an AWP up still, because JW continuing to invest in some of these deagles and utility means that he won't have enough money to get the AWP out anytime soon, unless he wants to go for a glass cannon. And on the T side, you know you're going to be dealt a lot more nade damage within the early rounds of things. The CT's quelling the pushes with those Molotovs and HEs. So as we get back underway, the AKs come on through, and we'll probably see those same smokes. No, we won't. Four trucking straight into the white walls here. Could be fast towards that B side of things. Crim's throwing a smoke towards Yard. Oh, this is standard from Flusher, but towards box holes they go. Mantu, you have to deliver.
Oh, yeah, he does. And he has found Golden going round the corner at a million miles an hour. Holding the line.
Alexi's taken main already.
He has, and he's even working on the flank. I think he's called the inner hit. MBK's going through backtracks. All of the CTs are ready for this. They're locking the door behind them. This is some proactive CT play. Mantu's got the call. He realizes he doesn't have to give them anything. Playing around the smoke. It's getting me a bit sketched out.
Okay. Someone's just taken the gap for him.
If you're Alexei, surely you just pause here, right?
He should play to contain, but they've also got another on the flank of Issa here, so they can put pressure on.
Yeah, they can, and they should, because Flush has just found two of them. A crucial frag found by Valda, quickly traded. Brolin to plant, two on two, both from behind. Brolin could get caught here, but Crims is there perfectly.
I didn't expect this.
Uh-oh.
He's walked past him.
Oh, heard him.
Timing. He's going to get one, but he knows where Brolin is. Desperation.
That's a fumble. That is a fumble right there in the end zone. I don't know anything about NFL, but that seems as close as a reference as I can make.
Honestly,
there.
It sounded pretty real.
It sounded bloody
legit.
That's
a fumble in the end zone for sure.
Yeah, but I just don't understand how they let that go. They had three players towards the site. They had two on the flank. They had their opening kill advantage as well. And in transition is where OG lost this. So that shot there, great. Flusher gets a kill. But at this point, Mantu should know that low ramp's open. Volder in no man's land tucked in towards high ramp. And then this here from Issa. He's stuck with some big decisions, but oh, man.
I mean, yeah, you can sit there in hindsight and say how you could have played it, but it's a caught out in a very sticky situation, and it does put the second on the board for Fnatic. Ivy, part of the map that hasn't seen too much action as of yet.
Spot on. And also, remember, look at that utility. It's sparse for the CTs now, and a missed shot gives opportunity. Now it swings a little. They can work with this. That timer, yes, it's 120, but when you've already utilized your smokes and everything else, that feels like a lifetime.
Yeah, I mean, if you can just say Ivy player, no smoke, you've got a whole lot of time to start trying to manipulate and exploit that. Nothing fast on the plans here from Fnatic. Flusher, I'm interested to see his crosshair placement for this take, even a little pop flash tutorial from the man himself. Nice.
Goomba.
From Flusher. Practically a Goomba. Rush starting to get a tingle. Alexei, gonna have to back out of that one. That's AKV MP9. Now the smoke's outside, or at least one. That's actually just gonna block off five. I see E-box flying through as well as Ivy. It's gonna be outside smokes, but unless they get info, these CTs are gonna over-rotate. There is nobody on inner here. Nobody. Two smoke grenades has pulled them all over there. If Crims walks down this ramp, Lauren, this round's over.
It feels like it almost is already, but we have to see Fnatic now commit to this. There's that smoke going towards B, and now it looks like Fnatic's intentions are clear. It's late in the day. This is a very poised and reserved Fnatic. I'm not used to this, running the clock quite late, but obviously with the utility and what was there, it makes sense, and they've got a clean round here. Maybe they could cost them something on the way out, but this is surely a round win.
Yeah, so just a bit of logic from the OG side of things. Taking the gamble stack towards the yard with the number disadvantage, they were hoping it was going to be that A side attack, and with it not, they're just going to hold on to their guns. But look who is coming knocking. JW taking one gun away here. The more damage he can do against these save rifles, the better for Fnatic. So he flashes, he picks, he faces forward as the remainder of the Fnatic members start to comb out across the map. They need to clear towards main and towards old bomb train. That's where the remaining OG members are. They've set up the net and the bomb now with approximately 10 seconds left. means that the chase will start to come on in. Money isn't fantastic, so you can see they're not rushing this here, Fnatic. They're taking their time. But they're getting rid of that AWP could be huge.
See if they can remove it. Golden's taken one. Mantu will retain his for now. Let's see if he can keep it. Oh!
Big kill from Krims.
Oh, lovely. No way. Oh, that's a souring mood right there for OG. They had two scoped weapons. It's enough to win a CT round. This is the pop flash off the pipes and completely blind. Flusher descending onto Issa. That's the loss of the orb.
Oh dear, wow. That was so close. That is really
You went for
unlucky.
The wall bang. Like you can't, at least if you don't laugh, you'll cry. That's the conversation. Timeout called for so they can get those tears out of the way. But regardless, it is just how the cookie crumbles. I do fancy a cookie.
Oh, a little cookie.
Crumbly.
Rush said he was going to bake some cookies.
Rushley?
I do want to make some cookies, yeah. I mean, I just need to get the ingredients and put them in the mixer and get them going.
Yeah, man. And I was going to make cookies. All I need to do was go get the ingredients, put them in the mixer, then put them in the oven, then take them out, then eat them.
I think a few more steps than
I was
going to
do. You might need a day off for that.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Maybe Monday.
Maybe we take like multiple days off, like almost two, and call it a weekend. What do you think?
You've got another 16 days, I think.
Oh, God, don't tell me the number, Chad. I'm going to go crazy. Brolin has solved the problem. Alder, the only threat, now dead. So that org, the chance of this round being one to remember, starting to dwindle.
Can I propose something? And I don't know if ESL's obviously, you know, hopefully they're listening, as this round should be kept clean. I'd love just like a random segment from Tony once in a while. If NIP ever play, we just have, you know, Tony's Corner.
Tony's Corner.
Tony's Corner.
He just comes in, he's chilling out, a little cup of tea on the side, he's in the armchair, relaxing, watching the games, and we just have a little chat about it, you know?
I'm totally down.
Just for some wholesome... we've got confirmation of potentially we'll see what we can do. I like that. It's very shaky, but I'll take that.
Talking of potential, Lauren, I reckon there's potential for a Zeus frag here.
Oh, you think?
I think so. Crims or Brolin might get
How
a little...
How far do they go?
Oh, look, he's guarding the org, you naughty boy. Oh, he's just staring at the only weapon he could possibly save. And he's even taken it away with him. No, not for you.
What sort of crosshair would Brolin be using? What do we think here? Is he a classic thin green?
I reckon he's a thin green boy.
It's tiny, it's thin, it's impossible to see.
Thin green boy.
Ridiculous.
We know what Flash is using.
Yeah, so the Fnatic guys have got good eyes. We've learned that much.
Yeah,
I love that dot crosshair.
How does he see it?
I mean, it's a little different, I'm sure.
His res has to be different, surely, yeah. Well, Crims must have a big boy crosshair, I reckon. Golden?
Oh, they're all quite similar.
Crosshair? Anyone have a big boy cross? Here we go. Now we're talking. Now we're getting into my neck.
Oh, Nathan, what is that?
Teeny.
Okay.
Tiny.
Everyone rocking a baby crosshair. Where's the dynamic?
We're talking.
Here we go. Chad's back in the server.
Oh, this is it. Nice and chunky.
You should have seen Henry's. I think he pretended. He tried to play it off like he was doing it for a joke.
Oh, look how funny I am. It's like, but
I've lived with him. I've seen the crosshair. He does just have an absurd, I think it's size 5.
Gigantic.
Size 5. Falder's on his way for some early CT info, and as he turns the corner, so does Flusher. Dink exchange the org. I reckon if he was a step closer, he gets that one-shot headshot.
100%. I think you could be onto something there, and that is, unfortunately, the letdown of the org.
1 HP. God, just kill me.
Hell.
Well, it's all right. He won't actually know the damage. He doesn't get that recorded in console.
Yes, that is a good tip to remind those of.
He can't go, he's on one. He can just say, I dinked him. That's all he can say. So retooling right now, Fnatic with Flusher low on HP. They might want to leave him to lurk. Having him invest in anything early might be a bit of trouble. Mantle will be flashed back, but will it hold him
brave
at bay?
Dude. Look at him. Look at him.
He could be under something here. You won't expect this re-aggression. And you'll see the bomb early.
It's a game-changing move if he gets it. He gets one. Does he get out? Yes. Brilliant. That's kind of equaled the playing field, keeping in mind that Flusher is 1 HP.
J-dubs, though.
Naughty.
Sneaking behind enemy lines on the backtracks. Brolin wants to bring the bomb. Issa can flank, but JW, he can find the opening. Hiccup strike. JW to do the same.
I think they should pincer onto Yard here with 25 seconds.
He's tucked in on the halls. He won't be visible, but he could come all the way through Z here. NBK's got his knife out, and hello. Gap found. Gap exploited. That's the bomb. Mantu wants to win this round, and he's doing a fantastic job at it. Regardless of all of that flanking, Alexi can find Flusher. It doesn't matter, though. He's 1 HP. The SMG is perfect for the job.
Time.
Yeah, round one. Pre-fire. JW does get the frag. They just have to survive here. Grim's low. Lower now. And Alexi survives to win the round. Recovering the AK-47, it's a dream. OG finding five, but Fnatic keeping them on their toes. And look at the money. Oh, no, in victory, Chad. And you're sitting there with 3K. The T's have got a better buy than you.
Yeah, that's the problem on the CT side. If you can't establish a bank and you're losing so many members, having to drop guns across becomes, the only decision you have. So they were able to get that AWP for Mantu, so that's not going to be too bad for OG going into round number 10. But Crims, he didn't have any options. Like, do I go up the ladder and see if I get lucky,
or do I
just like let him get away and we lose the round? Well, you better to give the round a crack, and Fnatic will be able to buy again. Can they punish this? Low utility. Well, they whiffed that Molly. It actually is helping them.
Oh, Issa is going to try and keep... Everything. The flash was perfect, set into motion by Alexi B, and everything falls to pieces. SMGs, it doesn't matter. Now they're on the AKs. They have the perfect weaponry beside them, and Golden's left scratching his head. They got proactive even when their money was not favorable.
Well, Golden, he needs to live by that magic number, get as many kills as he can here to keep this CT econ low. But I think he might be flashed, Molly, naded, and smoked out of position here for a little while. We have Issa with a smoke as well to drop. They can pick up these AK-47s, three of them now, and while he's locked on in by Mantu's aggressive Ivy push with the AWP, Alexi B covering off towards the white walls, and at this point, it's only a matter of time until Golden goes down. It's just how many can he take down with him? Jiggles, sees two, gets nothing. So a clean round from OG, and a very important round for them to get here, because what that means for the money on the Fnatic side is they're working with less than optimal cash for a full buy, but enough to go for a buy. Now, I'm really sitting on the fence here as to what Fnatic will do, because we have seen them go for a couple of more conservative rounds than normal. And yeah, again, they're going to go for that conservative play. Mm. So Deagle's coming out. Nade again.
Loving that from Issa, though. When you haven't got the utility and you just bring the fight to them.
Take the space.
Yeah, it costs Fnatic the round just like that. Blink of an eye, double kill into the third on the org recovery.
I also really want to roll my mind back to how JW got that space from Ivy before, because he managed to get around the whole back of B, so I do wonder if that's something that eventually they like to return to. At this point, however, obviously not really the round to be testing that out in the bigger picture, but you know, maybe these Deagles could do a little something. Flusher sent over.
They've only fired one Deagle. Golden's trying to make it look like it's one person selling something.
I hate those door-to-door salesmen. I guess that's not a career anymore, is it?
Not really.
Definitely.
All right, well, no one there to receive those nades. Ooh. OG ready for this.
That's a perfect incendiary. And actually, I don't know if the audio cue was heard, but they were very loud in their retreat. Seems that Mantu's preparing himself for the main hold. It is only Deagle, so I will reiterate that this shouldn't be too much of a threat for OG.
Got the utility out if you're, you know, going down the checklist of small victories rather than round wins. It looks like they are drawing them towards the B side, so maybe they could punish anyone if they're not keeping their eyes on the prize. We'll see if any of these Deagle shots do land. It's going to be obviously quite tricky considering the amount of AKs that have now been filtered through. Valdo handling Golden. Oh, we're taking a fair bit of flak, an uncomfortable fight, but a victory in the end.
Yeah, this has been just an open and shut case. OG very much going to be happy with the fact that they've recovered themselves a little bit of Deagle action, as well as, of course, not losing a single man. Seven found. Back to the Fnatic rifles, though. And to take a look at when those rounds were found, it has all been on buys. Three of the four posted by the Swedes with a bomb plant. So getting that bomb down takes setting up that after plant a big win condition for them. That's stating the obvious, but it's been done.
So the gaps that they found so far is towards the inner site and then through Ivy, like Lauren was highlighting, with JW slinking into the back lines off the opening kill and rotation. So yeah, they're ready for this towards that B side of things. Same opening smokes coming on through. Oh, it's deeper opening smokes.
Crims is out and about. He took a really wild fight. Did eventually trade with MBK, but Mantu.
The orb?
That's the bomb! He's going to back the hell out, but that's another huge casualty. Golden's going to be putting his fist through his desk if this keeps happening. The bomb lost in limbo. They will have to slow down to recover that. I say slow down. JW's doing it again. That's twice now. He's got behind enemy lines. He's so good at this. Threading the needle. Spots one. Back turn. Taps at the head and disappears upwards. Heading to heaven. Trying to keep the CTs guessing. He's doing everything he can. The bomb has been retrieved in the meantime. JW's on the hunt for Valda.
He's not going to expect this. Oh my god.
Nearly had it. One on three. Just
Nice shot from Volta there to close things down. 8 on the board for OG. Now things are looking very good for OG here. Golden with only 2 kills right now. If we're starting at the bottom of the barrel for Fnatic, and we'll work our way up. Brolin and Crims at 6 apiece, and then Flusher and JW with 7. I wonder if we'll see the AWP come out if Fnatic want to take some fights with the T-side at AWP. JW's the one making room with the rifle, but also the primary AWP for the squad. So those questions right there are going to be difficult to see when they get answered. Moving into the next round of play, the loss bonus has built on up for Fnatic here, so they should be able to get a buy through comfortably. But it's just, again, these pistols upgraded with utility. It never feels threatening. It never feels like they're able to get started. They need a bit of a miracle, an opening kill from one of their individuals, potentially snowballed into two. Brolin's the man who seems to pick it up when the chips are down. As Volda towards that inner site will be there by himself. Closest in rotation is Mantu towards connector, and he is going to head on over now. So we can see there are 2 players posted towards the B side of things, and all 5 members of Fnatic up in those box halls, ready to throw out these smokes and flashes. 3 in total. You want to close down the distance with these. Smoke goes down, flashes to follow. Spam is good.
Very good. He found Flasher and he's sticking around, just controlling that speedway. Double. Bomb down, though. That's pretty much the only reward Fnatic get for this inner take. It looks like 9 is completely and totally set in stone. BK confirms it. Just the defuse. They'll go and grab themselves a little pistol upgrade, and it's Issa's responsibility to get the defuse down. 9 on the CT side of train. If they can wrap this up and make it 11, OG's pistol will have enough to determine the fate of Fnatic's map pick. But as we outlined and we've seen before, Chad, I don't think Fnatic got too many T rounds on that comeback.
I think it was 6.
Okay.
But then they had a really rough start to their CT half, and then they had to come back and take us all the way through to overtime, if I remember rightly. So at this point, if Fnatic can grab another round, we weren't too worried about the Swedes just here. This is a semi-final. This is where they should be doing their best work. And with the money situation where it is, I do think that the AWP should come out for JW now. They've tried enough rounds of the same. Let's give a little bit of a different look here going into the final few rounds of play. Volda, we wanted to see that form continue. 15 kills for him, 11 for MBK, 10 for Issa, 9 for Mantu, and 7 for Alexi B. So everybody on OG delivering here within the early stages.
An aggressive brown holes push from Mantu in particular, just it bodes well for the series. Seeing him take initiative, taking aggressive orb lines, it really gets under the skin of Golden as well. He's currently conceded 11 deaths to 2 kills. That's a very good sign considering this guy showed up to the roster as a secondary orper and has made the primary role transition better than many.
And then swinging my attention back to Fnatic, this feels like the most controlled Fnatic I've ever seen, or tempered. It doesn't feel like that normal explosive style. I'm looking for antonyms for explosive because this doesn't seem like Fnatic. And maybe this is credit to OG for controlling them, for keeping that hand quite close and tight around the throat. But again, even with JW finding room, we've had a couple of bits and pieces like, oh, that's Fnatic style there. It's not really paid off too much.
Yeah, they haven't been able to get out main or pop and really make space. And if you can't get out into Olaf, if you can't get behind your own smokes because you're being shut down by the CTs, that takes away a big part of Fnatic's playbook in the chaos. They haven't been able to cause that here. So they have had to opt and try and take advantage of OG's approach. Very, very good so far with the way that they've quelled attacks through main and pop. Utility usage has been on point, and Issa has been a big part of that. And they've also had some of those random plays coming on in, which has just kept Fnatic having to go with these defaults. Well, if they're going to push, we need to wait. And what's the best way to deal with that? A default across the map. So you can see here, they're set up in similar fashion once more. Crims towards Ivy. We've got Flusher up towards the box holes here. And now the bomb is coming all the way back towards the B side of things. So with 45 seconds left, the indication that it will be a B finish is very, very clear at this point. Now, Ivy is the only real gap. And now that they start to get a little bit inquisitive, hold up, Volta's been flashed up. He spotted that. That wasn't the bomb, but they know there's some players in box holes.
So this could, look at Crims' work. Yes, it's drawing attention, but it's going to be to what cost? At this point, we'll see if OG can keep it quelled, and they do. Again, dealing with Fnatic's nonsense, and they're already out towards B. Valda, dangerous, but still very prevalent.
Could find Brolin. Should find Brolin. But won't. And now, squandering the spray, the flank is on its way. He needs to find something. Does eventually. NBK onto Brolin's push as well. Flusher in the brown halls. That's a threat. JW on the site hasn't made too much of a noise. Now they spot him. He's trying to buy time for Flusher's flank, just tucking in, and Flusher has found NBK. Oh. He's got a nade. Could finish off the job. It's Mantu that does just that, and there's plenty of time for the defuse. So with double kills being delivered on the retake, another plant, but falls flat.
Yeah, this could be a very, very good start from OG here. If they get 11 on this CT side of train, get that T side of pistol, they're off to one here. We know Fnatic, when the pressure is on, they tend to turn it up, but the pressure at this point is mounting to a point where maybe that won't be possible. The fact JW couldn't get anything done from the site there with the AWP meant that AWP was in the worst position possible. And Mantu just mopping up that final frag.
We have royalty in the chat as well. No Tail, OG's founder, and of course, multiple TI champion tuning in to watch his boys play. Probably got a big smile on his face at this point in time.
Sure. Didn't you tell me the OG Dota lineup was quite similar in the aspect? I will come back to that because I love the story you told me about with that. But for now, it does look like Alexi B once again controlling Fnatic in every single way. These guys, Fnatic, aren't being able to play their style at all. Everything they try and, you know, corral into it simply is being met by one good utility, great positioning, crosswise, everything you want. Bit of aggression from Mantu, throw it in there. Whatever you fancy, it's all working well for OG.
Yeah, and the thing you were asking about is just the Jordan. Of course, they had a player from Jordan on OG. They had a Finn. They had a Dane. It was
had a Frenchman.
Quite similar.
Had a Frenchman.
I see.
They had an Aussie. Maybe OG should have just tried to buy JKS, see if they could get him.
Complete the perfect
cheap,
story.
I've heard.
He's very cheap, JKS.
Not a lot of money going there.
Definitely not a high prospect.
He's a prize chook.
He's a prize chicken, he is. He absolutely is. Or a chook, if you're from the other part of the world, the Upside Down. That's from something, isn't it? What's
Stranger
the Upside
Things.
Down? Thank you. Haven't seen that.
All right, not a lot of utility here. 40 seconds left, and to get out onto the site, it's going to be difficult. They're trying another fakie boy strat here as JW needs to find a pick.
He might get this. Oh, his toes.
Holder. Oh, he's dead, and that's basically the round over. Look at this passive setup. I love it.
Stop your yammering. It's not over yet. Could be now. Yeah, Golden's found one, but quickly traded now from behind. MBK strikes. He's looking good. So good. Triple kill from the natural born killer. Golden to clutch, can do this. Valda says no. 18 kills to the Dane and 11 to OG. Off to a flying start. And this is Fnatic's map pick.
Destiny, I feel a champion waking inside of me. Stronger. Oh.
and I'll take it. Yeah. Reminding myself to just let go.
Eleven rounds on the CT side of Train. It's certainly not out of the realms of possibility, and OG have proven that. But Fnatic, not necessarily out of the running. A pistol round conversion, a first win on the gunny, and suddenly we're looking at an 11-8. Can be competitive, but something inside of me keeps telling me that OG have got this one in the bag. You can see that the mental side of things and the mechanical side of things are going swimmingly in one direction in the server. But things can change so quickly in the world of Counter-Strike that we love so much. Plenty of util on Alexi here, Chad. What you reckon that Molly and Smoke have got in store for us?
Could be late round here if he wants to use it for the bomb.
After
train.
Plan, yeah, I'm into it. At the moment, they are all postured up. If Bronn goes looking main, which he is, we could see a stack here.
Well, they're just going for presence, or are they actually going to go towards B? So now, as we can see the rest of them tucking on in, it will be the B side finish. Alexi might even want to drop this deep towards connector for them to push up on, because the smoke is deep. The Molotov, it's being saved right now. There it goes. It's just been lobbed out towards connector. They want to take space.
Such orderly fashion to this T-take so far, but damage is being inflicted right on back. Alexi B loses life, and you see Golden very much attentive, but a curious plant, quite a deep plant as well. It looks like they're postured to fight, but JW more than happy to greet them on that. I don't know if you're going to win that fight, but Issa still has a lot to say until then. Suddenly, it's just the two of them.
Yeah, it's over. Falder with such low HP, and he's being flanked. He might take a cursory glance, but Roland finds him, takes the P250, but you can see the idea. The forward plant, do you believe that was part of it, or was that a heat of the moment thing?
I think they thought Fnatic were going to play a little bit more retake and they'd get more site control before being peppered on up, because if that was the case, if that deep connector smoke linked in with Alexi B's Molotov normally would have given them control almost towards the backtracks. And then from that point, being able to fight and stay close to the bomb, not worrying about your flanker who would have been involved there dying, and then the bomb getting defused while everyone else is pushed up. That's why a deeper plant maybe was considered here. But I'm not quite sure of what OG are going to get away with these Galils. We see three of them.
Here we play who won the first round.
A UMP, a MAC-10. Yeah, it's pretty nice stuff over there on that T side of things. The only thing they're really lacking is utility at this point. For Fnatic, they've had to buy on in with these Famuses. And JW with the only M4s already been tagged on down to 14. So a great dink coming in from MBK. Bit of an old nemesis right here.
I need to do a bit of that baton relay. That's the bomb spotted, I think. Yeah, Alexi B showing first, forcing out the Molotov, and the CT side, yes, they are slightly better equipped on utility, but it is still sparse.
Oh, but look what they just wasted as well. Another Molly dropped towards low ramp and a smoke towards high ramp, and now this passive setup from Fnatic. The most forward person they have is the player in Pop Dog, being Brolin.
I legit think that strat was, come with me, yeah. Show bomb brown halls.
And we'll fall back.
And we'll fall back.
It's worked wonders.
It has. And what's also interesting to me is look at JW. Just give me one flash of it. Look at that, how passive he's fallen into so he could support the potential in a hit. It gives him space Ivy as well.
Prims is going to be feeling very hot under the collar here when the flank comes out from Ivy and main at the same time. He's going to need to tuck on in and away or hope that Brolin can bail him out here. Smoke come over. That's going to lock out Brolin's position. And Prims has gone of his own.
Yeah, but they're going to disrespect that. Straight across, if anything, gives them a guise to get out. Crims realizes he's vulnerable to Ivy. The first frag is found. It's going to get chaotic. Lauren, strap yourself in. This 30 seconds could get messy or not. Crims tidying things up quickly.
Yeah, Crims got our little dustpan. He's putting everything in a nice little order. No problems. Oh, I thought it was going to be frenzied. I expected, you know, maybe a little bit of surprise, but apparently no surprises here. But Mantu,
go on.
Show us something. You've got 19 HP, a Galil, and now you ain't got your life. So Fnatic maintaining calm under what was actually quite surprisingly not that much pressure in the end.
I mean, considering what OG chose to bring into that round,
right,
they managed to do an awful lot. And it wasn't the usual waiting and just hoping that the CTs throw it. They kind of forced their hand into that utility draw.
If there's one thing that we've seen from Fnatic here that has come in time and time again, it's been delivering when they're behind.
It's true.
Now, one of the things they struggle with is closing when they're in front. They lost that 15-9 scoreline on Overpass against Vitality in one of their earlier group stage games here at IEM New York. Now, with the scoreline at 11-6, you're about to see it most likely go up to 11-7. If Fnatic convert against the first gun round, well, we're back on. So, Ivy, that's the presence. Alexi B about to dodge the nade. Valder was the one who copped just a little bit more damage on that one. Both now within the realms of 80 HP. 89 for Alexi B. Holder on 85. Good year, 89. One of my favorites.
Yeah. I was nothing but a glimmer in my father's eye.
Minus 3 years old or something, was
four,
it?
Yeah.
Four.
Minus four.
Excuse me. JW, though, dealing with the Ivy presence quite well, and obviously that little other threat that was building, also been found. This is all quite comfortable so far from Fnatic, and you want to keep this clean. Flusher,
he's got five bullets. Why is JW such a badass? Just reload.
He loves it, though. What if he gets both with five? Look at that.
He's going to... Okay.
I recorded a clip from one of our games last night, guys.
You did?
Of one of you.
Mm.
And we'll play it later on the show.
What did we do? Who did something cool? Lauren, you had a round. You
Lauren had,
like,
had the pistol round against that Timber guy who held it sandbags.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, that was cool.
Mm.
Timber killed us all.
Yeah, we did
play
sandbags on pistol.
I've been enjoying Counter. I'm getting better. I'm just
You're playing really well.
I'm starting to understand how Counter-Strike works. All you had to do, if anyone's wondering, is watch Counter-Strike 6 days a week, 12 hours a day.
And breathe. Remember
and
to breathe.
Breathe, obviously. That helped me in my oopsie moment.
To be fair, I hear you breathing, so I can confirm either.
I do previously forgot to breathe. Alexi, though, lungs full of air, looking to deflate Brolin's. Oh. Boop! There we go. Exacerbated is the young Swede. I don't even know if that word is relevant, but it felt like it was.
Exasperated?
Exasperated?
Yeah, for
accelerated.
I think the key in there would
Masters of Counter-Strike.
Wow.
This has found JW, but at this point in time, it is still not a lock-in. If he could find Golden's Hunt here, he knows it's a possibility.
Oh, the timing on this.
Yeah. I like this, though. If he holds this angle, chances are he gets one of those two jewels. Mantu hoping to work his way out, but Green Train could be a threat. Flusher, he's very passive holding this now. He's just hoping to catch anyone crossing on the walk up.
I like that little deeper line he's holding.
There is totally one-on-ones to be found here.
Sure. I mean,
they're not gonna clear this.
Good...
Oh my God.
Apparently do that. Yeah, it was a deeper little off angle. I really thought Flusher had a lovely little watch on that, but Crimson now fancies the chances and the knife switch is going to cost Easter his life. Not even a chance to fight back. And honestly, even with gun out, I don't know if you'd still expect it.
Easter brought a knife to a gunfight. No fun for anyone. Crimson Golden, though.
They did see Mantu's position.
That was so long ago, and he has got the bomb on his back. So surely, if he was to wait, give it 15 seconds, one of them's going to have to acknowledge he could be going in. No, Golden's found him.
And they get the AWP in time.
Yes.
All right, so picked up. That'll be given on most likely to JW or Flusher if he wants to play retake towards that side of things. Now, Fnatic are one of the teams where they do have a primary AWP, and an AWP who has played that weapon for the majority of his career, but he's happy to use literally any weapon in the game. And I'm not over-exaggerating when I say that. So while they hand it over to Flusher from time to time as well, and it looks like JW was gifted that here going into the next round of play. Round number 20 coming onto your screens right here is the scoreline now 11-8, and this lead that once felt so threatening from OG has quickly trickled on down to a similar buy and a similar scene to what we saw within that first half. OG down to just a light upgrade of pistols and utility behind it. Can they be more threatening than Fnatic, though? Because theirs look limp and weak.
I see JW, I see an AWP. I smile. Doesn't get the first, though, and now there's actually a lot of players down there. Only aware of one for now, but cognizant there may be plenty more. Alexi, nade. There's actually a lot more nades. It wasn't just Alexi's, but the one I noted does get put in, but it didn't really find much. So again, the early initiative towards Ivy actually paying off not too much. I guess showing presence is about the only thing you can really report from that.
And this is similar scenes as to what we saw from Fnatic. So if you missed the first half, you would have heard me explaining on these rounds where they are just down to the pistols. Percentage Counter-Strike at this stage of the game will make you force the CTs to use all of their utility. And why would you want them to do that? Well, they'll have to reinvest. And if they have to reinvest, oh, that Molly's gone a little bit skew-if, hasn't it? I'm not sure if that was intentional or if they wanted that to dip in a little bit more above the pop dog, but that would stop them from setting up nades towards yard. So Brolin here, they know that he will be in towards that pop position. Fake towards Ivy right now from Alexi. He's drawn the attention of one. Actually, leaving the inner bomb site right now will be JW. So all eyes on Flusher here. Only has an MP9.
Ooh, this is scary times. 25 seconds. They have to commit pretty soon, right?
They certainly do. And already losing one man. They're into the site now. Flusher does have his signature MP9, known to ply his trade well with the SMG. Now with two missiles and a frag. This is the crucial... And now the second as well. If there's a third, okay, we're cooking. Valda needs a headshot. He needs a fresh clip. He's still alive for now. One headshot's all he needs, and he finds it. Brolin to clutch. It looks like OG are doing it with pistols. Valda's not got the health, though. And so Brolin will save the day. But my God, four frags and a bomb plant off Deagles? nobody's complaining.
Yeah, we said Fnatic were looking limp. Well, this one here from OG was the opposite of that. Bloody hard stuff coming into round number 20, and they've made it an almost winnable round. Unfortunately for them, it will be 9 posted on the board for Fnatic after those heroics with the Deagle, but the buy can come on through. Mantu can get his AWP, can get the head armor and even utility behind it here. So no woes in the OG camp whatsoever. Everyone will be able to buy in with those AK-47s. And they're going into round 21 fully equipped with the loss bonus at 3,400. So if they lose this round with the residual cash they have on 4 out of the 5 members, they will be able to have a threatening buy going into the next round. Whereas Fnatic, their economy, it's been kept honest. Crims, JW, they're dealing with a bit, but Flush Up, Brolin, Golden, they're in a little bit more trouble. Their loss bonus is not sitting as pretty.
Looking at those double orbs as to how we get them into play here. Brolin very close by to several players, but incredibly calm under this. And let's see where they're posted. So Flusher popping himself towards A and JW, towards Ivy. So it is, again, Golden very alone here on B this time. So trying to ensure control. Smoke goes in and we're getting towards the minute mark.
Yeah, so one of my favorite players in the Pop Dog role is Brolin. And one of the things that separates him from others is his ability to read when he's needed. See already, he's just fallen out of that ladder. He is vulnerable to a totem drop, but he has some allies.
This is huge info.
Yeah, nothing Ivy. Crims can fall out. He's rotating in.
Yeah, they can play 2 towards the inner bomb site. Brolin's dropping on back now, not to give up his life, because if Brolin goes down in towards pop, that means the avenue towards yard is open. Now they can use their utility to stall out. JW has a truckload, but can't use that in his position. Crims has a molly now when this attack comes in. Golden has the same. OG need to fight through the flames.
Oh, man.
It might even be a fake, actually.
It's going to need to be a hero play. Yeah, Alexianis's positioning suggests it could be the fake.
Time there at 30 seconds.
This is going to be a very interesting round. A very interesting 40 seconds or so. Flashes, Molly smokes, trying to pull the CTs into the fray. 20 seconds. Still not down the ramp. It will have to be the inner hit now. And here goes nothing. First for Crims, unloading the mag. Golden getting another on the cross. Golden needs a frag.
Seconds.
They need to plant the bombs loose. Need the frag now, and Golden's done everything. Single-handedly winning the round. Mantu wondering where on earth it all went wrong. He hits the flick to save his rifle. Won't get the same opportunity again. And just like that, Fnatic have done what they did once. They're doing it again. Closing the gap on the CT side, a spotless defense. OG have got no answers. 6 rounds on the trot. Golden loved the third here. That was the extra one, but that was the one that won them the round.
Yeah, and this here means that we most likely do see a pace change coming out from OG. The hero of that round was JW's information. He was able to clear that. Brolin heard nothing towards pop. They slowly trickled on back into a defensive setup and hedged their bets towards that inner bombsite, and that was the right call. The AKs come out, smokes towards yard, deep towards connector, and the Ivy positions, and down pop they go. So faster approach here from OG, but this is red. Lots of good nade usage from Fnatic here.
Gosh, I thought the molly might have been the end of it, but the guns are more than enough. Yeah, and Mantu frenzy tries to funnel in, and Fnatic seem too aware.
What a great transition Fnatic have had. They just seem to be so comfortable on that CT side. We've seen it twice now in 2 days where Fnatic can overcome the odds. Hello, smoothie moves from Alexi B.
This is about to be 7 on the trot right now.
Yup.
For the Fnatic side of things. So they're back in this one, and OG are struggling for answers. Want to keep it clean if Fnatic can. They've already lost one of the expensive rifles. It's been picked up from Crims, and he'll actually finish off Alexi with exactly that. So now, without the plant, OG's money comes into question. A couple of individuals there sitting around the 3,700 to 4K mark who will be able to buy AKs. And if they want to buy again, well, they can make it happen with Galils as well. But if they want the AWP for Mantu, they feel they need a bit of a crowbar to smash open an opening pick against the likes of JW and Flusher, they should save. They should just take a partial investment here, go for one of these pocket pieces, and see if they can get away with a bomb plant or another threatening round, because the closest round so far from OG has been those Deagles towards the B side of things.
True. But we've also just watched what happens when Golden knows they're coming. It can be a very one-sided affair. He's only got 10 kills, but I feel like the majority of them come when they hit the site.
Ooh, keep your head down.
Yeah, that nade could be the one.
Ooh. Oh,
a little bit shy there.
It's a hard nade to throw.
Yeah, it's not a fun one. That's why Alexi, he did his from a standing jump position. Rotation's already here, so they've done the same thing as they did previously. Baited out a little bit of early utility, and that was easy. But now, if they want to make a round of this, they have to force forward. They have 3 smokes. They could use one of these towards low ramp, one of these towards Well, maybe they'll wait out that smoke right there. But as we head over towards the side of things, if you can limp out a smoke high ramp, that'll give you an opportunity to either pick down and clear out the coils position or fight towards the bomb train.
There's a timer on this. Brolin's pushing main. Flusher, he's going to drop out his incendiary. It's not quite going to slow them down. It is. Okay, so one of them slips the net, and it is the responsibility of Golden to clean up. Alexi wants the plant. He wants more. Issa pushing in, goes down. Alexi with the fake, trying to find Flusher, and he's hitting every shot he fires. Now Alexi's Deagle fills the feed enough to buy time for the plant. Mantu to defend him. Mantu down just to 21, an unarmored Deagle goes down.
Alexi needs the ace here.
Yeah.
You don't ask for much, Alexi. Just kill them all.
And all of them are looking at you. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to go down. His Fnatic continuing their spotless CT run. We have seen them from the first of this half just pick up a slew of 8 rounds.
Can we get the scores on the doors up, please, Rushley, with your little bind? Back it on for everybody at home here so we could just show how dominant... Yeah.
Here we go.
All right, so you can just see how dominant it has been here in this second half. It's only blue. That means only Fnatic rounds so far, and only 3 rounds they've had to defuse on these. So the first was the pistol, then round 20 and round 23, the one you just saw. And those were the rounds with only the deagles, right? Only those pistols in play. So all in all, Fnatic against the gun rounds have been looking clean as a whistle.
And I also want to highlight that, yes, Brolin may not be, like, fragging out, but his information he's finding every single time, he's been able to call, I think, 2 or 3 rounds now that, hey, no one's here. We've either cleared Ivy, main, whatever it is, but a pace change. Alexi B's already out, quickening a little. Not quite as frenzied as maybe you'd want, but it looks like the CT side, in response, getting proactive, and Vald has left this. So this is going to be, once again, information relayed, and Alexi B... He found a way out, but what does he do with this now?
He has to wait until this smoke clears or go now, and well, it looks like he's going to be waiting. So, interesting smoke dropped on out there from Voldert. I guess that's covering off towards the Olof position, because that could be under the CT remit right now. MBK clearing it. Now they know nothing's home. They're moving forward. Brolin's been spotted up towards heaven. Mantu can go for this pick, knowing Brolin's been seen. Oh, they're so ballsy. Look at all those flames.
It's allowed a gateway to the site, but the bomb's yet to be planted. There's still almost all of Fnatic keeping eyes on this. Keep in mind that flank from Golden will eventually come through, but MBK's won his fight. There's the flank coming in, and now suddenly the back is very vulnerable.
Yeah, the power of Golden's position now just makes everything more awkward, and it enables Crims to find one. This is trying to relieve the pressure. Landing the dink, but here's Flusher. Fnatic just locking them in. This hurt locker, Mantu's digging them out. An exceptional double. I am concerned for the swing. He's tucked in now, though. Doesn't stop JW from finding him. They don't have a smoke. Do they guess Golden needs to get that on the bomb now and has done exactly that? Alexi with a lot to do. Whether or not the dink from Issa has been communicated, it could change how Alexi plays
this. JW has to defuse.
One, needs a second, and oh no, he's adjusted the spray, it's there. OG get their first round, and it's a gift from Alexi B. A gift indeed, and it keeps on giving. You can see the CTs have got plenty of cash to keep going after their 8-round run. But now OG are on the board on their T side, and it's not through anything other than Mantu and Alexi B. Finding Flusher, piecing together the necessary frags. This was close. You can see on that top of the screen. About half a second in it.
That's the way you probably would have wanted it anyway. You know, the higher HP player going for that defuse there. But Golden, if he had the AWP, then maybe they may have been able to work, make that one work. But good stuff between Mantu and Alexi B there to finally pull off a round for OG. They've stopped the spell.
I do want to remind myself that that started with Alexi B getting so much room towards outer. He was out and about looking towards E-box. He was already kind of around this, playing around the smoke, so a little further ahead and able to clear. But this time they lost out on MBK from Brolin being quite proactive. So again, then obviously couple that with the flank that came in from Golden. However, Mantu a little stuck in here, takes way more damage than he wanted. It all calms down for a second now.
JW loves to search for these kills if he knows someone's crossed, and he's doing exactly that right now. He loves this type of a play.
Left eye, surely it
favors. Yeah, but it's so unexpected. That's the thing. It's so unexpected. You never expect an Ivy player to reinitiate like this, and JW, he goes for it, and he's actually going to get punished this time round. So Issa not allowing JW to get away with any of his antics and drops a lurk smoke. So this keeps Ivy under question. Brolin will have to look over there at some point because currently it's a 2-2 setup. In towards pop is Crims. Brolin playing in transition. He's got a lot on his plate. Unable to finish his food either there. So Mantu walks away with his life, and Crims, he will grab one, but it's all going to come down to the rotation here. Look at Flusher.
Oh, Alexi B again trying to bail him out here from these tricky spots, but look where these two are. Both in towards pop. Mantu, how do you lose that fight? I thought it was his all day, and now Golden in the 1v1. Issa's position, I don't think has been revealed recently, but Golden's perception is incredibly high. He understands the likelihood. Touches on the bomb, but now Issa has the chance. And yeah, the shot comes out. Well played by Issa in the end.
1v1s to close out these rounds. Well, it was a 1-on-2 in the sake of Alexi B's round, but this one here was another 1-on-X for OG to get across the line. And Fnatic now, they've actually, off the back of those 2-round losses, had their cash whittled down to a place where they will have to take a save. And that's all it's taken from OG. 2 rounds back-to-back and dealing with Fnatic, who haven't held on to any of these CT-sided rifles. Thought this might have been enough right there as they did catch them by surprise, but Issa, fantastic work, does even save the AWP. And now real problems for Fnatic here as we move forward. 13 to 12, they've gone for a partial investment. P250s, Deagles, and Scouts out to play. Can be decent if they hit those tags, but wow, Mantu, that was quick.
Yeah, he says he's doing it for the team. Never wants to let his team down. His actions speaking volumes as he's stacked up another. JW walking through. What was his intention?
Nade in hand as well. Interesting little play there. Suicide Bomber on the CT side.
The Martyrdom perk.
Don't see that every day of the week.
See if he can... Oh, now it's a good challenge. The COD 4 perks. Deep impact for the penetration. Stopping power for the bullet damage. What else have I got?
No footsteps because it's dumb.
No, that's not... That was not in the competitive rule set. Dead silence is for the console noobs.
Always has to be mean about it.
Does.
Well, I've seen a clip, like last year with the Esports Awards, they had a clip for like Clip of the Year that was a Call of Duty clutch, probably on the console, where they couldn't hear the footsteps.
It
was
so stupid. And they won it over Chris J's clip?
Yeah, it was like, what are you guys watching?
A lot of the competitive COD from the console thing, they believe that hearing footsteps is for noobs.
Sorry, what?
Oh, I know. I haven't bothered to take that fight on Twitter yet.
It's not worth it.
It was a bunch of meatheads smashing their heads into bloody remote controls.
I mean, it's ridiculous when you sit there in Counter-Strike and, you know, we talk about the power of audio cues, etc. But maybe in the pace of the COD gameplay that they're so used to, for some reason, not making steps is the pro way of doing it.
Well, the auto-aim helps them as well, so that's
Yeah, that's
good.
True, but when you're only aiming with your thumb instead of your whole hand, you might need a little help.
Get a mouse.
One of my favorite console versus PC storylines. Obviously, Chad's one side of the spectrum. One thing that's cool is there's a player in Apex at the moment called Snipedown.
Snipedown's amazing.
He's competing versus mouse and keyboard players with a controller.
And he's got to.
And he hangs.
Yeah, no, he's actually
sick.
That's
pretty sweet. That's something that we joked about. We said, it's never going to happen, but someone's doing it, admittedly not in a game I follow too closely.
If I'm honest, Snipedown, I think, was a Halo player as well.
Hold on a second, guys. About to get hot.
Yeah, Usher. It's very hot.
Ooh, I was thinking God tier, but maybe not more on the human level, but Krim's still able to provide something, but that's a plant coming out, so this retake is going to be tricky. You've got that orb still in play, and you've got
a
nice molly as well. MBK doing wonders, forcing the smoke out, forcing them to respond. Brolin's position.
There's no kit.
Ooh, does it do anything?
Nice frag from Brolin. Maybe they go for it because of it. Mantu relieves the pressure. And still frags coming in. They're going for it. Closing the gap. MBK only an MP7. Multiple targets. He's alive. That's a big
time,
one.
Though.
Yeah.
He's got the molly.
If he gets the molly right, can't screw it up now. They use their smoke because of MBK's molly.
They have to save.
He's done it.
You can't do anything.
That is magnificent. Golden gave it a go. The sound cue to try and draw him into the frag, but he's done his job. The power of a Molotov, folks.
That's 15.
OG definitely starting to find a grip on this T side, admittedly by the skin of their bloody teeth.
So that's another 1v1 situation.
Yep.
So out of what? The last 4 rounds, three of which have been 1v1s, and that one there was a 1-on-3 where all he had to do was throw a Molotov, didn't even need to find the kills. I thought this here was enough from JW, but they weren't able, even if they found the frag, wouldn't have been able to get the defuse. So Mantu has won that just with that Molotov, that $400 investment right there coming in clutch. And Fnatic, well, backs against the wall going into the final round of play here potentially for map number one, their choice. 15 to 12 down.
Okay, the nades have found the target. The heat-seeking missile finds Golden and pops him down to 17 HP, feeling a little worse for wear now. And yeah, four rounds on the trot for OG. Got to be feeling chuffed with this. Is Man 2 going to be posted across? JW on the other side now. And that from Brolin. Information now to be relayed. And map control garnered, but JW gets it right back at him, losing sight now towards Ivy.
Another smoke. Yard's in trouble here. They've even tucked in more passively. Crims has left. He's left into connector, and now he's in limbo.
How does Valdez's role do anything here? I mean, obviously he's just holding the brown horse. He's only got a Molotov. He can't really sell anything. He's going to try, and that's it. Yeah, a spray and a Molotov is as best as he can do to keep Golden and Flush's feet planted. It is working at this point in time, but the Ivy focus, of course, continues.
JW's about to be in a lot of trouble.
Oh, it's a tight line. If they flash, he has to fall off.
He might have seen a gun then, just on the weapon switch. Molly Smoke obviously now knows 100% there is someone still hanging around. 25 seconds, the timing couldn't be better. JW sees nothing, still finds it. Crims then called into attention, wow. Bomb now dropped. Crims ready for the follow-up as Alexi B can wait, but all the CTs are now here. Mantu's gonna have to dig deep again and he can't go anymore.
Passive hold from Fnatic, it's wonderful.
Yeah, but they're only going to get away with that so many rounds in a row here. OG should be able to punish that knowing what's coming on in. If they want to take space and then wait out the utility of Fnatic, then synchronize for a couple of mid to late round duels with some late smokes towards connector and towards that Ivy position. They should be able to get bomb train control here. So JW, flash, smoke, well, still gets the kill. Easy as you like. And Crims, well, we know that he can be an absolute rock. Picking up a big kill as well. They're over towards the back of the bomb train. 15 to 13 now. Freeze time ticking on down. Money, oh dear, starting to become a problem for OG as well. Only a $1,900 loss bonus for them in the next round. So going into the final round of play, if they lose this one, they won't have anything. This is important for OG to make something work. Low utility, AWP. Alexi's out to find space. And the miss from JW.
Yeah, that's something. Gives Alexi a new lease of life. He is fully developed now, getting the Ivy smoke down. He's taking so much space around green.
Here they come.
Last time this happened, he got that 1v2 at the end. That early success was great for him, but now he needs more. He needs the rest of the team with him.
There's the first. Alexi does manage to make this early presence profit. Don't want to let anything slip away now. They've still got so much time and so much control, but Golden on the bomb train connects. Alexi needs more. Golden continues to be a thorn in their side. Valda does find the necessary. All onto Flusher. OG to take Fnatic's map pick away from them after a very quiet start. Four in a row towards the closing stages to make it the final 16 to 13. And this semi-final looking poised for